Attention to politics. Now, there's a push by some members of the NDC minority in parliament for a motion of censure against the finance minister, Ken Oforiatta. In accordance with Article 82 of the 1992 Constitution, the minority motion has been signed by almost all members of the minority caucus, making it admissible on the floor of parliament so it can be moved by the House. Following President Akufo-Addo's July 1 directive to the finance minister to begin formal engagements with the International Monetary Fund, there have been calls from many people, including former President John Mahama, for Oforiatta to resign. Here's Member of Parliament for Pooh East, Dr. Kobna Donko.
I will say the minister should resign as a matter of honor for a new team to start the negotiations with the IMF and to chart a new course. I sincerely believe he's done his best, and everybody knows his best has not been enough. There may be extenuating circumstances, there may be. However, you take responsibility.
My colleague Elton Brobe joins me in the studio with more on this developing story. Elton, from your checks, how many NDC MPs have signed on to this motion?
So it is as at 11:30 a.m. This morning, 88 out of the 136 NDC MPs have signed. But interestingly, leaders on the NDC side, as Haruna Idrisu, Honorable Kruche Aveji, Muntaka Mubarak, and the other two WFs, have not signed on to this petition.
Mm. And what reasons are they citing? Is it clear to us or why some of the NDC MPs are not signing to this motion?
So there are two issues at play now. Now, they are concerned about the end game. One group on the NDC side is of the view that if they should push for the finance minister to be removed, the government appoints a new one and they perform, to what benefit would that have on the NDC and their chances of winning the 2024 election? There are those who also the view that if the finance minister continues and run down the economy of this country, to what impact would it have on the country? These are the issues at play. My information is that the NDC General Secretary, Johnston Siyedunkete, has given the full backing to the minority side to push through this motion for censure against the finance minister.
But Elton, walk us through the process about, you know, putting the censure before parliament and whether or not it is likely to succeed.
So such a motion will require 1/3 of all members of parliament. The NDC, they have 136, meaning they have the numbers to file for this motion, but they will require 2/3 of all MPs before the resolution can be passed, which means that they'll have to need support from the MPP side. My information is that behind the scenes, some MPP MPs may be supporting it, but as to whether they will officially back it, that is a bigger issue.
With their signatures. Elton, thank you very much for bringing us those details. Well, some members of the NPP have also made similar demands for the finance minister to resign. Listen to former chief of staff Kojin Pienin and former general secretary of the NPP, Kwabena Japon.
If I were the finance minister, this is a question of President Drove, from my utterance and then what is happening, I would just go, Mr. President, thank you so much. I think it's best for me to sit back for another person to take over.
I would think that on the basis of what he said 2 weeks before to the whole country, what he said to the whole country, which is that we will never go to the IMF and we are a proud country, we have the resources. And when you speak like that, you know, I mean, you should look yourself in the mirror and say, look, I got it wrong. Mr. President, I thank you for giving me the opportunity and I should stand down.
Well, we'll keep tabs on the story and we'll bring you more in our subsequent bulletins.